Hey guys, we got Blunder on, we caught him on the ladder, top 100. And here I'm going to show you some replays. So I usually start out with Clefable, with this deck. And especially because this kid didn't have anything that was like an obvious switch-in. Because Excadrill, yeah, he counters Clefable, but if I have Flamethrower or Fire Blast, I can kill him. So, I start off by getting my Zero Aura burned, which is a very huge mistake, I shouldn't have. And I keep bulk upping there. He goes into Ductrio, I think. And he's probably... No, okay, he goes into Clefable. And here I do massive damage. He wastes one of his best Pokemon. So yeah, I 2-hit KO. He soft boils and I think I plasma first again. No, okay, I do the right move. I knock off his life orb. I probably should have just plasma first for more damage, but getting the life orb off was good enough. So we see Keldeo 2-hit KOs Dragapult, but I can't risk getting KO'd by Dracometeer. I never know like if he is modest or whatever. So here I think I played Rocks, yeah. Right now I should play Dragapult or Corviknight. Yeah, we go Corviknight. And my wall strategy is to weaken his Rotom enough because it's the only real counter to Corviknight. And sweep with Corviknight later. But most of the times, like you can do it because like here he could burn me. So I go into Clef. Getting Clefable burned or poisoned is always good because then they can paralyze you like randomly with moves like Thunderbolt or Thunder or Body Slam. And it also absorbs a lot of status. So here I go Iron Head and then I kill Excadrill because I hax a little. Yeah, he has Sticky Barb. Okay, I didn't even need to hax because he was 2-hit KO at that HP. By the way, the tech of Clefable Sticky Barb wasn't invented by me, but like I found this this team on the ladder and I really liked it, so I started playing with it. Here I should have probably soft-boiled and I would have lived the Earthquake, but it would have been the same thing because I couldn't 1-hit KO. So I see that he's banded, or I would have resisted either way. And here I just go for the kill. He is kind of stupid for letting his Mandibuzz die. Here I think I should have saved my Jirachi for later Wish Pass, but I didn't, which is a huge mistake on my part. Okay, so he goes Ductrio. I don't know why I go Dragapult. Oh, to set up a substitute. So right now, I think I will Wisp. Yeah. I don't even know if I win this match, but since I'm making the video, I'm not going to cut it out anyway. So yeah, I Dragometeer. And here I just keep trying to get lucky, but as you all know, I'm not lucky. So yeah, I do no damage. And at this point, even if I crit, I wouldn't kill, so I would need 2 crits, which is impossible. So yeah, I go in on a Roost, and here I start spamming, I think, Focus Blast. No, Hydro Pump. Okay, I should have maybe spammed the Focus Blast, but Hydro Pump has a slightly better accuracy, so I guess it wasn't a bad move. So yeah, he can't Roost forever, so I would have killed him anyway. Maybe he would have stalled me, but... Okay, I hope I don't miss. Yeah, I don't miss. So, for his Dragapult, yeah, I get Corviknight. He Will-O-Wisps, I guess. No, he goes Hex. Hex is not too good, bro. But it does way too much damage. So here on the Will-O-Wisp, I go for my own Dragapult, but he predicts, and this is where I lose, I think. So yeah, he predicted me, but if he went Will-O-Wisp, then I would have probably like done some, I don't know, some damage to his Clefable with my Corviknight. I could have played it. It wasn't over yet. because also his Rotom was at 59, so it's not like it was super healthy. It's obvious I lose, so let's just skip this. Yeah. I'm going to show you another match. I don't even know why I saved this one. Usually I save matches that I win, but this one wasn't one of those. You see, it's even private. I made it private because it probably wasn't my best showing. So yeah, let's just go to the end. Okay, nothing I can do. Okay, GG. Yeah, GG, he played well. Nice predict on my Dragapult, or it would have been very difficult for him to win if my Corviknight wasn't burned. So yeah, let's see some other replays. We have a ton of replays. This was the toxic guy by patrol officer of my last video. So I'm going to show you. Oh, this Kangi guy, I've beaten him like 10 times. So yeah, let's just show him. Also, there is a guy who always plays this Sun team, which is like the usual Sun with Venusaur and whatever. And I always beat him too, like he quits. Okay, let's see this one. So I'm playing an unusual deck that is a very old meta, because there wasn't Pokemon Home, and I think there were still Darmanitan when I was playing this deck. So I get up the rocks, which is the only purpose of Mew, like prevent the opponent from getting up his own hazards. Oh, here I do the most amazing predict ever. He thought I was Scarf, but I'm actually Specs, because I have nothing that could stop that Dragapult. So I would have lost turn one, but since I'm a god. And here I notice his Excadrill is banded, because no way it does so much damage. He's very lucky that I get flinched, because I would have like done half the damage. He obviously isn't Moldbreaker, so here I just Sword Dance, because I have a red card, which is a pretty nice tech. Here I do a ton of damage to Hippodon, and he's very lucky that... Okay, I should have just played Shadow Claw for sure damage, but I was like, I don't know, maybe he's ballsy, he wants to go Earthquake or whatever. Okay, so here I keep going Sword Dance until he switches, so yeah. And I think here I sweep, because he has nothing to take my Hawlucha. You see, now I kill him with close combat, then I kill Dragapult because my Hawlucha is tech, so it has Throat Chop, real agent, like Blunder would say. Okay, he goes into Excadrill. Maybe he didn't know about Unburden, I don't know. I mean, those kids are on top ladder for no reason, like they play random stuff, like double sand with banded Excadrill. I mean, once you take care of Corviknight, or if the opponent doesn't have Corviknight, you won, because how am I supposed to stop an Excadrill without Corviknight? So yeah, he goes Whirlwind here, but it doesn't change anything, because I just Shadow Claw, I think. Yeah, then I go Sword Dance, maybe. No, I go Hawlucha, so he knows that he can't go Corviknight. So I just close combat and no, okay, wait, let's see. Whoa, what a predict, I didn't even expect it. I'm so good, like, literally. So yeah, his Dragapult is dead. Now I go into my Aegislash, and I risk everything going for close combat. No, wait, I Sword Dance, it's the same thing. Because I have Shadow Sneak, Mimikyu in the back, I know I won. For some reason he stays in, maybe he thought he could X. And right now it's just a matter of time. I have 400 attack even if I'm burned, so he's probably going to Lich Seed or something. Knock off, okay, nice move. Now I go in with my... Oh, here I didn't know, because he could have like actually won. Because see how much my Shadow Claw does. It does nothing. This is physically defensive Ferroturn. And I was like super scared. Here I thought he would have protected, but he probably didn't even have Protect. So yeah, I Shadow Claw. I do some damage, but I'm triple attack. So I'm like, okay, some fast math. My Dragapult is physical, I have no idea if it kills. I didn't want a damage call because this was my only real win condition. Because if I Dragon Danced, I risked getting knocked off and killed. And yeah, thankfully, Phantom Force killed. And Phantom Force is a move you can't protect from. So even if he used Protect, he wouldn't have been able to save himself. So yeah, this was an amazing game. The kid played pretty bad, but like, he made the right choices without knowing my team. My team is really special, so it's not like something you can expect these days. It's a heavy offense. And with this, I finish the video. And if you liked the content and the battles and my predictions, you can subscribe. Sorry for my English. I'll try to get it better. But for the moment, you have to stick with my weird accent and like my misspelled words. That's all. Bye-bye.